Shalom. Today I'm going to teach about why not to say the burden of Adonai. I'm going to read from Yirmeyahu, starting from verses 33 down to 39. When someone from this people, a prophet or a priest, asks you, what is the burden of Adonai? You are to answer them, what burden? I am throwing you off, says Adonai-Tzva'ot. As for a prophet, priest, or someone else from this people who speaks about the burden of Adonai, Yahweh, I will punish him and his household. So when you speak with your neighbor or brother, ask, what answer has Adonai given? What has Adonai said? Don't use the expression burden of Adonai anymore, for every person's own word will be his burden. Must you twist the words of the living God of Adonai-Tzva'ot, our God? So when speaking to a prophet, ask, what answer has Adonai given you? Or what did Adonai say? But if you talk about the burden of Adonai, after I have already sent you the order not to say the burden of Adonai, I will lift you up, burden that you are, and throw you off away from my presence. You and the city I gave you and your ancestors, then I will subject to you everlasting disgrace, eternal, unforgetful shame. When the Ruach HaKadosh first gave me this message, it struck me very strongly when I read the burden of Adonai. And even as before I proceeded to read, I'm like, burden of Adonai? Adonai has no burden. And as you can clearly see, to say burden of Adonai is an extreme offense to the Holy One of Israel. And I immediately thought about what is written in Matthew 11. And I'm going to read that to you now. And it helps you to understand why never to say a burden of Adonai. And I'll tell you right now, Adonai is omnipotent. He's omnipresent. He's everywhere. He lives in me. He lives in you. He lives in all creation. Hallelujah. He made all creation. He sees everything. His Ruach HaKadosh lives in those who love him, who have accepted Yeshua HaMashiach as their Savior. But remember, he breathed into the nostrils of man. Hallelujah! So our very breath comes from the Holy One of Israel. Nothing is too hard for God. Nothing is a burden to Adonai, because he is omnipotent. He can do all things. He created the universe. He created the heavens and the earth. Before there was a heaven and the earth, there was Adonai. Albert Einstein and all his genius could never come up with a mathematical calculation for the age of Adonai, because he is ageless. He always was. They say that minus a day for man, or for Adonai, it's like 1,000 days for man. So I see that it's like yesterday. For Adonai, it's like 1,000 days. I'm sorry, not 1,000 days, 1,000 years, I believe. For Adonai, the point is that we are alive a certain time on this earth. Hallelujah. We are mortal human beings. The average length of life, longevity, at least in the United States, is 80 years. Hallelujah. But Adonai was never created. Hallelujah. There is no mathematical equation that can come up with the age of Adonai. For he always was. Hallelujah. He is and always shall be. I am led to go to Exodus chapter 3. Bear with me. Exodus chapter 3, starting from verse 13. Moshe said to God, "Look, when I appear before the people of Israel and say to them, 'The God of your ancestors has sent me to you, and they ask me, "What is his name?" The God of your ancestors has sent me to you, and they ask me, "What is his name?" What am I to tell them? God said to Moshe, "I am, will be what I am, will be." In other words, he always was, he is, and he always will be. Hallelujah. So Adonai, no man can comprehend the mind of Adonai. He has no burden. Hallelujah. So what came to my spirit is, "Come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden, heavy burdened." Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 11, verse 28 to 30 says, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest to your souls. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you will find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." What does that mean? My burden is light. Think of a feather. Imagine a feather on your back. Does it hurt? Is it a burden? No. A feather is light. Hallelujah. So never use the term burden of Adonai. Hallelujah. Adonai doesn't have any burdens. That's why he says, remember, Yeshua. This is Yeshua speaking. It's the word of God made flesh. He is equal with the Father. He says, "All ye that are heavy laden," hallelujah, "heavy burden, come to me, learn of me, for I am lowly in spirit." Hallelujah. I am meek and lowly in spirit. Hallelujah. My yoke is easy. Hallelujah. Because he has no yoke, my burden is light. Hallelujah. Again, think of a feather on your back. It's light. So it's a high offense to Yahweh to say the burden of Adonai. So if you were ever asked anything about Adonai, whether you ask a prophet or anyone, never say, "What is the burden of Adonai?" It's an extreme offense to him because he has no burdens. He was, he is, and he always shall be. He's omnipotent. Hallelujah. Anything that has all power has no burden. Hallelujah. The Bible says the battle is not mine, ours, human beings. It's the Lord. The Lord can handle the battle. Because, hallelujah, he is omnipotent, he is omnipresent, he is God, hallelujah. Adonai has no burdens. So when Yeshua says, "My yoke is easy, my burden's light," he's really saying, "I have no burdens." Again, think of a feather on your back. Is that a burden? Hallelujah! My yoke is easy. My burden is light. Hallelujah! Yeshua has overcome the world. Hallelujah! Yeshua, the Word of God, made flesh. Hallelujah! Holds the keys to hell and death. Hallelujah! He's conquered Satan. He's conquered the grave. He is sitting at the right hand of the Father, where all power is. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Bless you, beautiful children of Adonai. Remember, greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. Adonai has no burden. Never say the burden of Adonai. Ask a prophet, what has Adonai said today? Adonai is all powerful. Adonai is everywhere. Imagine, not only is he with me here right now, he's with you, he was with everyone in the universe, even the animals in the fields. He sees, his eyes go throughout the earth, hallelujah, and he sees all things. It is written in Yeshayahu, as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts, hallelujah. I'm an artist. I used to paint. I used to draw. I don't do it anymore, but I did when I was a young woman. It would be the same thing as my painting, my creation, trying to comprehend my mind. Hallelujah. How ignorant is that? It's just as foolish for us to think that we can understand the mind of our Creator, who always was, who is, and always shall be. Shabbat Shalom. Hallelujah.